Hello everyone, welcome back to this channel FTSER. In this video, we will talk about a liquid piston engine, which many of you requested from this engine a long time ago, especially for the English version, where this engine is an improved version of the Wankel engine. So if you haven't watched the Wankel engine yet, you can click the link of the Wankel engine on the description column below. And why we can say this engine is improved and developed from Wankel engine? So in this video, we will talking about this engine further. Actually, there is very little information about this liquid piston engine, due to we can say this engine is new and still in developing, which this engine is improved version from the Wankel engine like we said before. And it is appropriate to build the world refinement of the Wankel engine, so liquid piston engine will cover some of the shortcomings of the predecessor, the Wankel engine as the last one was developed by Mazda, like more significant compression ratio where can reach up to 26:1, which this engine will be more efficient in generating a compression of power and fuel consumption. Even is claimed beyond diesel engine, which the compression ratio is still around 15:24:1. Of course, this engine will be compatible with any fuel, and it's also evidence with power that has been produced, where this engine has a great power to weight ratio in the experiment using gasoline, where this engine can produce horsepower up to 4 horsepower per 2 kg. It's equal to 1.45 kilowatt per kilogram. So this engine is 38% more efficient and lighter than a typical reciprocating engine. So if this engine is more powerful, lighter, and has more efficient fuel consumption, why is this engine is not in mass production? The simple answer is this engine is still in development, and also this engine has this advantage that cannot be tolerated. What is that? We'll talk about off the back after explaining how this engine can work. And now let's talk about all the liquid piston engine parts and how this engine can work. Okay, let's talk about the part first. Even if we look at a glance at this engine and Wankel engine is almost identical. Actually, liquid piston engine and Wankel engine has so many different parts and concept, due to there are so many improvements and additional components in the liquid piston engine. The first central part is housing. This part will accommodate the other parts, because this housing has some function as crankcase and cylinder block in reciprocating engine. The second part is a rotor, where this part has a function same as the piston, and next part is apex seal. Just from those three parts, we can see so many different of this engine, like the rotor originally like Doritos on the Wankel engine, and housing like Chitato. Make rotor like look Chitato, and housing look like Doritos in the liquid piston engine. Okay, next there is an eccentric shaft, where this part has many air intake holes and counterweight mass. The next part is separated counterweight mass, cover up front and rear housing. And to shorten the duration of this video, we will not highlight the other components like fuel supply system, firing order, etc. So that's all parts in the liquid piston engine. Now let's we continue to power cycle of the liquid piston engine. For the power cycle, actually is similar to Wankel engine or another common combustion engine, because the liquid piston engine needs 4 steps every 1 power cycle. There is an intake, compression, and combustion consisting of ignition and expansion, and the last step is exhaust. But the difference is how this power cycle can happen. So to make it easier to understand, let's look more closely at how the air can go in and out from the liquid piston engine. For the intake process, the air will come from the atmosphere through the holes on the eccentric valve. Due to in the rotor also has an intake port to the combustion chamber. That for intake port. And how about the exhaust port? The exhaust will be out from the other Dutch because there are two Dutch in the rotor, intake and exhaust. And after the gas is out from the exhaust Dutch, or we can also call it exhaust port in the rotor, the exhaust gas will continues to exhaust pipe and the rear cover to the atmosphere. Okay, that is how the air can go in and out in the liquid piston engine. I hope you can understand the working principle. And now we will be talking about the power cycle. The power cycle is very different from the Wankel engine, where the Wankel engine will do every power cycle step in the same place. Intake will happen on the rear top, compression and combustion in front of the engine, and the exhaust in the rear below. In the liquid piston engine, all step will do in the same place, which means every chamber can do its power cycle. Okay, due to every chamber can do a power cycle, so we will take one chamber as a sample. We will this chamber for explaining the power cycle. For the first step, of course, will be intake, where air and fuel will move in through the intake port and fulfill the combustion chamber. That can be done because there is a vacuum when the rotor moves and suction the air and fuel. So after the high side of the rotor move, passing apexial, the other high side will come and do compression to the air fuel gas. So when it is completely compressed, spark plug will spark and explosion happened. In this condition, the rotor will be pushed and continue the movement to increase the chamber space until the other high side of the rotor come. After the other high side rotor come through the apexial, ducts in that rotor will be exhaust port and allow the gas to pass through. This step is called exhaust, where the rotor will continue to move and compress until the rotor compress all of the exhaust gas waste. And that's all of the liquid piston engine power cycle. It's so simple. Then how about the disadvantages of this engine, which can make this engine has not produced yet? To make you guys curious, before we talk about the disadvantages, we will talk about the advantages first. For the first advantage, this engine has a good transfer of heat. The reason is, beside all the power cycle process it happened at the three combustion chamber of the liquid piston engine, this engine also has a unique cooling system. More than that, we can say it's the most excellent engineous cooling system in the world, because we can see this cooling system in the other engine. If the standard reciprocating engine uses a radiator or fin to reduce the heat, in the liquid piston engine we only need air to do the cooling process. So this makes this engine is capable of doing due to fan movement. It will increase airflow, which the airflow will send through the rotor. So we can conclude this engine doesn't need the radiator because the air through will be cooling it. And we think this advantage is the most astounding and most excellent advantage of the liquid piston engine. And for the second advantage, a liquid piston engine also has a very high compression ratio because the compression ratio can reach 26 to 1. That was great if we compare to the diesel engine though. Due to this engine has very high compression, so this engine claimed can work as diesel engine. For the third advantage, this engine has excellent power to weight ratio in naturally aspirated condition and can produce 4 horsepower per 2 kilograms. So that means a liquid piston engine can deliver a superior acceleration. On the other hand, as we said, this engine doesn't need a radiator though. And the fourth advantage is the engine only has a few parts. It means the cost for assembly and production of this engine will be cheaper. Okay, that's all the advantage of the liquid piston engine. Now we'll talk about the disadvantages of this engine. The first liquid piston engine disadvantage is the engine still used two-stroke oil. It means there's very little hope that the liquid piston engine can pass Euro 5 and 6. And for the second disadvantage, this engine is hard to modify, especially about the capacity due to the housing shape. But we think if we want to get more power, we can do alternative ways like applying a forced induction system and enriching the chamber with more fuel. And if we want to upgrade the capacity, we can do that by adding more rudders. It's the same as adding more piston in the reciprocating engine. And for the last thing, we'll talk about the conclusion. So the first shortcoming, as we mentioned before, is oil stroke, the main obstacle of this engine for passing the Euro regulation. Of course, that is why this engine hasn't been produced on a mass scale. But on the other side, we think this engine still has a chance due to the power to weight ratio. And it has fewer parts than the common engine, and this engine is still in development until we release this video, which means that reason can be a glimmer of hope for the liquid piston engine in the future. Okay, that's all guys, information we can share with you. Don't forget to leave up to the comment section below. If you don't mind, hit the subscribe button down. I'm Karir, see you in the following video, and thanks for watching.